Hello students, as we have started with the topic how to find the cube root, right? Now today we will do the exercise, see exercise 4.2. First question in that you are having is find the cube root of the following numbers by prime factorization. And the number you are having is 35,937. You have to find the cube root by prime factorization method. So you have to do prime factorization. So let's do it. 35,937. So just see, the number is not divisible by 2 because the number is not even. Then sum of the digit for checking for the 3. 7, 3 is 10, 19, 24 and 27. So this number is divisible by 3. So we'll go for 3. 3 ones are 3. 29 is left, 3 9s is 27, 23 is left, 3 7s is 21, 27 is left, 3 9s are 27. Again, it will be divisible by 3, 3 3s are 9, 29, 3 9s are 27, 3 9s are 27, 3 3s are 9. Again, by 3, 3 1s are, 3 3s are 9, 3 3s are 9. And 3 1 the 3. And this is the cube of 11. So by 11 only it will be going. 11 1 the 11. Then 11 2 the and 11 1 the. Again 11. 11 the is 121. 11 1 the is 11. So record the prime factorization of 3.35937. This is equal to 3 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 3. Again multiply by 11, multiply by 11, multiply by 11. And for finding the cube root, we have to do the triplet. So make the triplet for 3. We are having 3 3s and we are also having 3 11. So cube root of 35937 is equal to, from each triplet we have to take one prime number. So from this triplet, what we have? 3, and this is a triplet of 11, so 11 will take. So answer is 11 3's is 33. Okay. Now second part, you have to find the prime factorization method. By prime factorization method you have to find the cube root for this. So again we will do the prime factorization because the name has been given to you. By this method you have to find. So the number is ending by 5, so we will start with 5 only. 5 8s are 40, 5 5s are 25, 5 7s are 35, 5 5s are 25. Again by 5, 5 1s are 5, 3 is left, 35, 5 7s are 35, 5 1s are 5 and 5 5s are 25. Again by 5, 5 3s are 15, 5 4s are 20 and 5 3s are 15. Right, and this is cube of 7. So by 7 it will be going. 7 4s are 28, then 7 9s are 63, 7 7s are 49, 7 1s are 7. So we got the prime factorization of 42875 is equal to 5 is multiplied 3 times and 7 is also multiplied 3 times. So now we have done the triplet for it and we found that all the prime numbers are in triplet. So it's a perfect cube, and cube root for 42875 is equal to 5 into 7, that is 7 5s is 35. Okay. Yes, now see the second question. Find the cube root through estimation. We have to find the cube root of this number through estimation. And in estimation what we have to do? We have to put a bar on last 3 digits. And that last 3 digits will make first group. So we are having first group as, in first group we are having 683. And second group, whatever digits are left, what is left? 19. So 19 in the second group. first group is telling you the unit place. And you can see in the first group, the number is ending by 3. So, we know that 7 cube is 343. 7 cube is 343. So, any number which is ending by 3, its cube root will end by 7. Hence, unit digit of its cube root will be equal to 7, because the number is ending by 3 and it's a cube number, right? And we have to find the cube root of this number by estimation method. Now see the second group. Second group we are having as 19. Now we have to see that 19 is lying between which two cubes. The 19 is lying between 8 and 27, and 8 is cube of 2 and 27 is cube of 3. So 19 is lying between the cube of 2 and cube of 3. And in this process, for second group, the lower one, what is lower here? 2. 2 will be the 10th digit. So 10th digit of its cube root will be equal to how much? 2. Hence, cube root of 19683 is equal to 10th digit is 2 and 1 digit is 7. So your answer is 27. Okay. Now see the second part in this. We are having 85,184, and by estimation method you have to find. So first we'll put the bar on the last three digit, that will decide the groups. So first group, you are having a number in first group as 184, and second group is 85. Now in first group the number is ending by 4, and a number is ending by 4 means the cube is ending by 4. So what will the cube root? The cube root will go for 4, because 4 cube is, what is 4 cube? Cube of 4 is 64, and 4 you will get only in the case of 4 cubes. Hence the unit digit of its cube root will be equal to 4, because the number is ending by 4, right? And what is the next group we are having? We are having the group as 85. And 85 is lying between which two cubes? Cube number. So 85 is lying between 4 cube, that is 64, and 5 cube, that is 125. So what you will write here? 4 cube and 5 cube. So number is 85 is lying between the cube of 4 and the cube of 5. And always we are taking the lower one. So 10th digit will go for 10th digit of its cube root will be equal to 4. Hence, we have taken out both the digits. Hence, cube root of 85184 is equal to how much? 44. This is your answer. Okay? Yes, now see the third question. Find the cube root of -64/1331. So, they are asking for the cube root of a negative rational number. So what we are having, we are question is asking for cube root of -64/1331, right? And we have studied that if the cube root of rational number has been asked, so we can divide it into cube root has been asked. So we can divide it into numerator and the denominator with the cubes. So it will go for cube root of numerator upon cube root of denominator, and these are very known numbers to us. 64, right? 64 is cube of 4, and negative sign is there, so for negative cube root of a negative number is will go for negative only, so answer is minus 4, right? And 1331 is cube of which number? It's of 11. If you don't know, then you can go for the Frank calculation and you can find it out, right? If you want, you can see also 64 we are having, so 2 3 is 6, 2 2 is 4, 2 1 is 2 6 is 2 8 is 2 4 is 2 2 is and 2 1 is. So we are having 2 pairs, so 2 into 2 that is 4, and similarly we can check for 1331 also, okay? Yes, now see the second part in this. You have to find the cube root of 5, 1182 upon 2197. And this is in mixed fractions. So, whenever we are having the question in mixed fractions, so we have to turn up it into improper one. So, let's first turn up it into improper. What will be there? 2197 multiplied by 5. And then, what is added? Remainder. What you are having here? That is the remainder that will be added upon 2197. So let's multiply this. What answer we are getting? 2197 multiplied by 5. 7 5 is 35. 9 5 is 45 plus 3 48. 5 plus 4 is 9. 5 2 is 10. And in this we have to add 1182. So what answer are you getting? 7, 16, 9, 10, 11, 2, 1. We got the answer as 1, 2, 1, 6, 7 upon 2, 1, 9, 7. So what we are having in the mixed fraction we are having and we have turned up into improper. And the question is asking for the cube root of 5, 1, 1, 8, 2, upon 2197, and this will be equal to cube root of 12167 upon 2197, right? So this will be equal to, when we are having we have to find the cube root of a rational number, so we can find the cube root of the numerator upon cube root of the denominator. And separately we have to find. So let's find it down. What answer we are getting here? First let's see what number we are having in the numerator. We are having 12167. And we have to find the cube root for this. So this number is not going, it's not even, so it is not going by 2. 3 also, it is not going on. 5 also, 7 also. This is going by 23. It's a cube of 23. So when you divide this number by 23, how much you are going to get? 529. Again, 23, 2's up and 3's up. So it's a cube root of 23. Okay? And also you are having the number as 2197, and this is cube of 13. 13, 1's a, 6's a, 9's a. Again 13, 13's a, and 13, 1's a. So we got the cube root of both the numbers, numerator and the denominator. So our answer is, this will be equal to 23 upon 13. But this is improper. So we have to turn up into mixed. 13 1 is 13. What is left with? 10 upon 13. So this is your answer. Okay. Now see question 4. Evaluate cube root of 512 multiplied by 729. So we have to find the cube root of both the numbers. We can write it like this will be equal to cube root of 512 multiplied by 729. Will be equal to cube root of 512 multiplied by cube root of 729. Okay, so 512, we can find the cube root for this. 2 2 is 4, 2 5 is 10,
2 6 are 12, 2 1s are 2, 2s are 2, 8s are 2 6 are 2 4s are 2 3s are 2 2s are 2 1s are 2 6 are 2 8s are 2 2s are 4, sorry, 2 4s are 8 and 2 2s are 4. Now see the triplet, 2 triplet we are having, again we are having and again we are having. So here, when cube root of 512, you take it out. So what answer you will get? 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 2. So that is 2 into 2 into 2, that is 8. 512, cube root of 512 is 8. And 729 we are having. 729, this is divisible by 3. 3 2s are 6, 3 4s are 12, 3 3s are 9. 3 8s are, 3 1s are, 3 2s are, 3 7s are, 3 9s are, 3 3s are and 3 1s are. Here also we got the pair, triplet of 3 and again 3. So cube root of 729 we go for 3 multiplied by 3. So what we got? 2 2s are 4, 2s are 8 and 3 3s are 9. 9 8s are 8, 72. So 72 is the cube root of the given question. Yes, now fifth question is, multiply 6561 by the smallest number so that product is a perfect cube. Means you have to multiply smallest number over here so that whatever product you are getting, that is a perfect cube. Also find the cube root of the product. And to multiply this, what we have to go for? We have to find the prime factorization for it. Let's see. 6, 5, 6, 1. So, this will be divisible by 3. 3 2s are 6. 3 1s are 3. 3 8s are 24. 3 7s are 21. Again 3. 3 7s are 21. 3 2s are 6. 3 9s are 27. Again 3. 3 2s are 6. 3 4s are 12. 3 3s are 9. 3 8 are 24, 3 1 are 3, 3 2 are 6, 3 7 are 21, 3 9 are 27, 3 3 are 9, 3 1 are 3. Now, we are done with the prime factorization. So here only we can do the triplet also. 3 3 3, they are in triplet. Again, 3 3 3, they are in triplet. So how many 3 are left? 2, 3 are left because this is not forming a triplet. So I need one. What I need? I need one more 3 to multiply over here so that I can make the triplet for this. Hence, 3 multiplied by 3 is not forming triplet. Okay. 3 multiplied by 3, this is not forming a triplet. So, 3 is the smallest number to be multiplied in 6, 5, 6, 1 to make it a perfect cube. As you can see here, these two sets are in triplet. Only this number is not in triplet. We are having 2, 3. So, I need only 1, 3. So, 3 is the smallest number to be multiplied. And they are asking for the product. So, we are having 6, 5, 6, 1. Multiply by 3. How much you will get? 3, 1 is 3. 6, 3 is 18. 3, 5 is 15 plus 1, 16. And 6, 3 is 18 plus 1, 19. So, we got 19683 as a perfect cube. So we got 19683 as a perfect cube. And they are also asking for the cube root for this. Perfect cube. Now we have to find the cube root of 19683. Right? So, what we have done, we are already having the prime factorization for this and we have included one more 3 over there. So, from each pair, We'll take 1, 3 out. We are having first triplet as this, so 1, 3 from here. Again, second triplet is this, and we have made the triplet for this pair. So 1 more 3 is there, and cube root of this number we go for 3 3s are 9, 3s are 27. See one more thing in this. Suppose in this question, in spite of this whole number, if you are having, suppose you are having 2 1 8 7. In this number, suppose your question is what should be multiplied in 2 1 8 7 to make it a perfect cube. So what will happen? You have done here the prime factorization for 2 1 8 7. What you will do? This much will go for, and now you can see here we are having triplet for this. We are having triplet for this, and it is having only 1 3. Only 1 3 is there. So what should be multiplied in this to make it a perfect cube? So it is having only 1 3. So how many 3s are required to make it a perfect cube? Obviously, you can see that we need 2 more 3. 2 into 3 is required. 3 into 3 is required to make 2 1 8 7 a perfect cube. Hence, 2 1 8 7 should be multiplied by which number? By 9 to get a perfect cube. Okay, and then you can calculate down the perfect cube number. Again, you will get the same number, and the cube root will go for the same. Okay. Yes, now see the sixth question. Divide the number 8748 by the smallest number so that the quotient is a perfect cube. Also find the cube root of the quotient. And again, what we have to do? We have to do the prime factorization for the number we got. So we are having this 2 4 the 8 2 3 the 6 2 7 the 14 2 4 the 8. Again by 2, 2 2 the 4, 2 1 the 2, 2 8 the 16, and 2 7 the 14. Now by 3 it will be going 3 7 the 21, 3 2 the 6, 3 9 the 27, 3 2 the 6, 3 4 the 12, 3 3 the 9, 3 8 the 24, 3 1 the, again by 3, 3 2 the 6, 3 7 the 21, 3 9 the 27, and 3 3 the 9, 3 1 the 3. So we have to see the triplets. Triplet we are having, how many triplets we are having? We are having 3 3 3, so it is forming a triplet. We are again having 3 3 3, it is forming a triplet. Here is only 1 3, and I am having 2 2s. So neither the 2 is making a triplet, and even 3 is not making the triplet. So this terms are extra. 3, 2 and 2. Means this much is extra, and whenever we have to divide, whatever extra term is there, these are not making a triplet, so I have to remove this or I have to eliminate this. And how can I eliminate? Just by, we have to divide the given number by this number. So 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 3. Is not forming triplet. These prime numbers are not forming the triplet, and this is extra in this. So we need to divide which number we have to divide? 3 2's are 6, 2's are 12, by 12, by the product of these terms, because these all need, I need to remove it down or eliminate it down. So I need to divide this by 12 to get, so we need to divide 8748 by 12 to get a perfect cube. And to get a perfect cube we have to divide, so divide it down, divide by 12. This will give you how much? 12 7 the, then 2 the, and 9 the. 729, right? And 729 is the perfect cube. You can see here also, I am having 729 here. It is, this is the prime factorization for this.
I am having a triplet here and again here. It is a perfect cube. So cube root of 729, that is the quotient I got, is 3 multiplied by 3, that is 9. So this is our solution for this. Okay, thank you.